you ever seen that strange smiling plant known as the Venus flytrap and wondered to yourself, how do those things actually eat the flies they trap?
Let's find out on today's episode of
Colossal Questions.
The Venus flytrap is a strange plant that only grows naturally in the coastal bogs of North and South Carolina in the United States, basically in a 60-mile radius around the city of Wilmington. It's called a flytrap because, as you probably know, it's famous for trapping flies in its toothy leaves and might be the most well-known carnivorous plant, but it's far from the only one. That's right, there are actually around 630 different species of meat-eating plants scattered across the planet. But don't freak out. There's no giant freaky flower out there eating people. Just small plants eating lots of flies, beetles, spiders, and other insects. Carnivorous plants use a bunch of different methods to catch bugs. Pitfall traps that lure them in with sweet smells only to trap them inside. Flypaper traps that lure prey to a sticky surface. Lobster pot traps that are easy to enter but hard to exit. And, of course, snap traps, like our friend the Venus flytrap. Plants like this have a big leaf divided into two and hinged in the middle with long trigger hairs coming off the end. The plant then lets off a sweet smell that attracts insects and tempts them to get close. Whenever a bug finally touches one of the hairs, the plant snaps shut. Once a bug is trapped inside, the flytrap starts to ooze out stuff that help break it down quickly, until it becomes a goopy, soupy liquid that the plant can absorb. Like any other plant, the Venus flytrap still gets energy from the sun and soil through photosynthesis. But it grows in poor, wet, swampy dirt. That's where the flies come in. What the bogs lack in good soil, they more than make up for in insects. So, over time, the flytrap evolved to eat the bugs that were plentiful to make up for the energy that's missing. Believe it or not, the Venus flytrap is on the verge of becoming an endangered species. This is partially due to human development and habitat destruction, but more than anything, it's due to poachers who steal the plants to sell. So, while they may seem pesky, thorny, or even downright mean, Venus flytraps are our friends, and we should make an effort to keep them safe. At least in the real world. Game over.